shall sound and time shall be no more. And the morning breaks eternal, bright and fair. When the Savior net shall gather over on the other shore, and the room is caught up, you narrow me there. When the roar is caught up yonder, 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 I'll be there. On the bright and cloudless morning, when the dead in Christ shall rise, and the glory of his resurrection share. When his chosen ones shall gather to their home beyond the sky, and the roar is caught up yonder, I'll be there. When the roar is caught up yonder, 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 I'll be there. When the roar is caught up yonder, I'll be there.
shall sound and time shall be no more. And the morning breaks eternal bright and fair. When the Savior net shall gather over on the other shore, and the roar is caught up yonder, I'll be there. When the roar is caught up yonder, 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 I'll be there. On the bright and cloudless morning, when the dead in Christ shall rise, and the glory of his resurrection share. When his chosen ones shall gather to their home beyond the sky, and the roar is caught up yonder, I'll be there. When the roar is caught up yonder, 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 I'll be there. When the roar is caught up yonder, I'll be there.
Thank you. the trumpet of the Lord shall sound, and time shall be no more. And the morning breaks eternal, bright and fair. When the Savior net shall gather over on the other shore, and the roar is caught up yonder, I'll be there. When the roar is caught up yonder, 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 I'll be there. On the bright and cloudless morning, when the dead in Christ shall rise, and the glory of his resurrection share. When his chosen ones shall gather to their home beyond the sky, and the roar is caught up yonder, I'll be there. When the roar is caught up yonder, 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 I'll be there. When the roar is caught up yonder, I'll be there.
Wonderful to greet you on this wonderful sunny Perth day. Good morning to everyone here in the room, and good morning to our people online. It's wonderful to welcome you to worship this morning. If you look around the room, people might not be as sprightly as they normally are on a Sunday morning. We did have a wonderful time at Are You Smarter Than a Youth Group of 2.0 last night. So thank you to everyone who came along last night. It was a great time of fellowship. Some healthy competition together. It was a good night. Bit of a late one, but a good one. So, our call to worship this morning comes from Psalm 100, and it says, "Let the whole earth shout triumphantly to the Lord. Serve the Lord with gladness, come before him with joyful songs. Acknowledge that the Lord is good. He made us and we are his. We are his people, the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and bless his name, for the Lord is good and his faithful love endures forever. His faithfulness through all generations." Amen. We're going to start this morning by singing a rousing song of "Oh, What a Wonderful, Wonderful Day," which it is. So would you please stand and sing with me?
Thank you. Our scripture reading this morning comes from 2 Corinthians chapter 5 and commencing at verse 6. Therefore, we are always confident and know that as long as we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord. For we live by faith, not by sight. We are confident, I say, and would prefer to be away from the body and at home with the Lord. So we make it our goal to please him, whether we are at home in the body or away from it. For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, so that each of us may receive what is due to us for the things done while in the body, whether good or bad. Since then, we know what it is to fear the Lord. We try to persuade others. What we are is plain to God, and I hope it is also plain to your conscience. We are not trying to commend ourselves to you again, but are giving you an opportunity to take pride in us, so that you can answer those who take pride in what is seen rather than what is of the heart. If we are out of our mind, as some say, it is for God. If we are in our right mind, it is for you. For Christ's love compels us, because we are convinced that one died for all, and therefore all died. And he died for all, that those who live should no longer live for themselves, but for him who died for them and was raised again. So from now on, we regard no one from a worldly point of view. Though we once regarded Christ in this way, we do so no longer. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, the new creation has come. The old has gone, the new is here. Amen.
Good morning. I would like you please to stand, because we're going to sing this very old song. And I know we're a contemporary group, but we're just going to do things a little bit different this morning. Thank you. Now, when I was growing up, I grew up in Ireland, as you can obviously tell. And during the summers, my mother loved me so much that she used to send me to my grandmother's for the whole of the summer, which was great fun. So my mom was an officer, so it was easier to get rid of the kids. And I used to stay with my gran and my aunt, and we used to have this great time because my gran was this Corps Sergeant Major and my aunt was the YPSM, and we used to go on YP trips, and it was just so much fun. But my aunt actually passed away just a couple of weeks ago, and although we didn't have very much growing up, my aunt didn't have very much throughout most of her life, she had this assurance that Jesus was hers. And in this world, it's full of riches, of many different things, but the only one thing we can count on, and the only thing that matters, is that Jesus is ours. So we're going to sing this song, because it's great to have this confidence that Jesus is ours.
Blessed assurance. Spirit, wash
sing my Savior all the day long.
I like the old songs. It's often been said that then you will never look upon the face of anybody that Jesus doesn't love. And being a Christian, it's just so nice to be able to sing this song that here I am to worship, because no matter who you are, Jesus died for you.
Join with me in prayer. Lord, we thank you for the assurance we have that you are with us, that we can come before you and confess our sins, knowing that forgiveness is found in you. As your word is brought to us this morning, we pray that we will have receptive ears and hearts, that we can set aside the things of the week past, the things of the week to come, and focus solely on you. In your name we pray. Amen.
Good morning, everybody. Welcome to Fortress this morning. Welcome to those in the room. Welcome to those online who are sharing with us. We hope that we enjoy our time. We're sure that we will enjoy our time here this morning in God's house. Majors Al and Deb are away on holiday at the moment, and we're grateful that Kirsten is leading the meeting this morning. And we have Major Emma McIntyre with us this morning, who will be preaching. Major Emma is actually the assistant manager at the Harry Hunter Centre, which is our rehab centre in Gosnells, and we're grateful that she's here to share with us today. Last night, for those who were able to take part in Are You Smarter Than a Youth Grouper 2.0, I'm not quite sure how it worked because I didn't see youth groupers doing the quiz. That's okay. In total last night, there was 120 in the room. So before we talk about how much money was raised, that was a great way to share together. And it wasn't just our core folk. It was core folk and friends and family and people from other core. So what a fabulous way to celebrate last night. Over $3,500 is the current count. So well done, everyone. I think we'll just bank that applause and we'll just pay it forward for the team who organised it. Thank you so much. The youth leaders who did all that and all the members of our youth who did that, thank you. It was an amazing way to pull all that together. I think a special thanks. We can have another clap for our MC last night. Sam did an amazing job. Thank you. I hope that those online took the opportunity to share with it last night and that you were successful in either your bids or in the quiz. We have a men's breakfast coming up. Now, it's a little bit of short notice, but every time we try and plan it too far ahead, COVID hits. So we're trying to go ahead of COVID now. And this Saturday, men's breakfast at 8:30, the car park will be open, and it will be in the normal place we do it, in the doorways outdoor area. So all males are welcome, including the older young adults. So you're welcome to share with us for a breakfast this Saturday morning at 8:30. Thank you. Now, Keith Armstrong had a fall going back a day or so ago and had an operation yesterday. So he fell in his driveway and unfortunately caused some breakages in femur and something else. There's more details than that that I don't want to get wrong. So he had the operation yesterday and he's come through that. So we're very grateful that he's on the mend now, but please remember Keith in your prayers at this time and family. And also we know that there's quite a few of our congregation who are going through surgery or who are going through treatment at the moment. We remember those people as well. We do specially remember David Anderson as well at this time. David's got an operation coming up this week, which is very serious. So we think of all those people. And please, if as a congregation, we can remember the people of our core who need our prayers, especially this week. Thank you so much. On another point of needing prayers, Robert made it to 50 this week. So congratulations, Robert. The prayers were for Vanita, obviously. The Chinese Corps, just looking forward a little bit. On the 27th of June, the Chinese Corps are going to be having a takeaway lunch, pre-packaged, professionally done. So this is a Chinese lunch if you want to take part. Tickets are for sale and they'll be in the foyer after the meeting, $12 each. It was to coincide with having lunch with the MSB. Obviously, COVID struck that one as well. MSB aren't coming, but we've still got the lunch. So if you'd like to have a takeaway lunch, you can either share it here or you can take it away. That's $12 per person, but you do need to buy tickets. It's professionally catered. And we are the proceeds from this one are also going to the YP trip to Adelaide. So that's YP Band and Timbrels. Thank you, MC Sam. Oh my goodness, I'm getting heckled. We do continue to seek volunteers for the coffee booth. That's starting in July after the meetings. And that's the end of the announcements. You can clap for that if you like. Now we will receive your tithes and offering. Thank you. Thank you.
Hey kids, it's time for Kids Spot. So today I've got with me a little container, and it's full of some cotton balls, and this is going to be almost like a little garden. So now in this garden I'm going to plant some mustard seeds. Now I don't know if any of you have ever seen mustard seeds, but they are tiny. They're actually the smallest of all seeds. So I'm going to put some mustard seeds in the container. Okay, yep. So got some mustard seeds in here. And then what's something else that, you know, all seeds sort of need to grow? Yes, what do they need? Water, correct. Okay, so got some water. There we go, make it, yep, nice and wet there. All right. What's another thing that plants maybe and trees need to grow besides water? Yes. You're right, sunlight, correct. So kids, if you're at home and you want to do this, make sure you put this container maybe by the windowsill so it can get enough sunlight. So what's the whole point of this demonstration today? these mustard seeds, Jesus, when he was talking to all his followers and all his people, he said that the kingdom of God is kind of like a mustard seed. And although it's really small, did you know that these mustard seeds can actually grow into a really large tree that's about 6 meters tall? And that's the size of a house. So think about it. Something so small as a mustard seed can grow into such a large tree. And Jesus was saying to all his followers, and he said, in the same way, the kingdom of God can also grow. And though it might sometimes, we might seem small, we ourselves are all a huge part in actually growing the kingdom of God. And that might just be doing small acts. You could just be talking to one person and telling that one person about God, and you yourself are actually helping to grow the kingdom of God. And you can grow the kingdom of God in other ways. You could just by showing love to others, you know, love to others, and that's just demonstrating God's love and growing the kingdom of God. And kids, in the same way, even though you're also small, you know, like a little mustard seed, you also can play a really big part in growing God's kingdom. You can tell your friends and family just how much God loves them, and you can show other people love and be really kind to them. So, if kids, you can go home, try this, make your own little garden, and if you want, you can come after the meeting and I can give you some mustard seeds and you can go home and you can plant them. And yeah, that is all for kids' spot. So I think the kids, it's time for you to head out now.
Good morning, everyone. Now, as the kids are on the way out, we're just going to hear the Bible verse Kathy was just teaching us about. Second Bible reading this morning is from the book of Mark, chapter 4, and it's verses 26 to 34. It's entitled The Parable of the Growing Seed. So Jesus also said, "This is what the kingdom of God is like. A man scatters seed on the ground. Night and day, whether he sleeps or gets up, the seed sprouts and grows, though he does not know how. All by itself, the soil produces grain, first the stalk, then the head, and then the full kernel in the head. As soon as the grain is ripe, he puts the sickle to it because the harvest has come." And again, Jesus said, "What shall we say the kingdom of God is like, or what parable shall we use to describe it? It is like a mustard seed, which is the smallest of all seeds on earth. Yet when planted, it grows and becomes the largest of all garden plants, with such big branches that the birds can perch in its shade." With many similar parables, Jesus spoke the word to them, as much as they could understand. He did not say anything to them without using a parable. But when he was alone with his own disciples, he explained everything. We're now going to hear the message from the band.
Thank you. Good morning, everyone. Lovely to see you. It's a privilege to be here today to share God's word with you. And as I start, I'm going to ask how many of you are familiar with Roald Dahl's writings? Okay, got some takers there. How many people have heard of his revolting rhymes? Okay, anyone in the band? Okay, excellent. So Roald Dahl has shaken up some of the traditional stories that we knew growing up. And what he's tried to do is take a story that we thought we knew, give it a bit of a shake, and kind of shock us into thinking, that's not how it goes. That's not quite right. So I want to recap your memory on Little Red Riding Hood. Now, my recollection of Little Red Riding Hood, she says, "Oh, Grandmama, what big ears you have. All the better to hear you with." Then she says, "Oh, Grandmama, what big eyes you have. All the better to see you with." And then inevitably she gets eaten by the wolf. Is that everyone's recollection of Little Red Riding Hood? Okay. Let me read to you the take that Roald Dahl has put on. So she says, "But Grandmama, what a lovely big furry coat you have on." "That's wrong," cried Wolf. "Have you forgot to tell me what big teeth I've got?" "Oh well, no matter what you say, I'm going to eat you anyway." The small girl smiles. One eyelid flickers. She whips a pistol from her knickers. She aims it at the creature's head and bang, 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 she shoots him dead. No. Now you might wonder why the crazy person is telling you the story of Little Red Riding Hood. But do you know Jesus often used his parables to take a group of people and tell them a story that they thought they knew, and then all of a sudden it hit them with a truth that really surprised them. So let's pray before we continue. God, we thank you for this word. We thank you for the living truth that is in this word. And today, as we open this word, we ask that you would open our hearts and our minds. We thank you for the intellect that has created pictures and stories and faith within us. But we ask today that you would open our eyes anew, and that our mind would be opened, our spirit would be surprised, and we would be greatly encouraged by what we find today. We ask in the name of Jesus. Amen. All right, so Jesus is preaching in Galilee. He's by the lake. And just before this, it says that there's people there from Judea, Jerusalem, Idumea, regions of Jordan, and Tyre and Sidon. So we have here a very diverse group of people. We have people from all over the place, different faiths, different backgrounds, different occupations, different landscapes, different things, and they've all come together to hear Jesus. Now, Jesus thinks, what can I use, what can I talk about that will help these people understand what the kingdom of God is like? He says, I know, I'll use a seed. And you would have seen that tiny little seed that we used in the children's story. Because everyone knows what a seed is. Everyone can understand that. Doesn't matter where you come from. Doesn't matter if you're a farmer or not. You understand a seed. So he says, this is what the kingdom of God is like. It's like a seed. You put it in the ground. And then very, very quietly, this hidden potential that is in that seed comes to life. It doesn't happen overnight. It doesn't make a big fuss. But it starts as a seed, and then it says it goes to the stalk, and then it goes to the head, and then it goes to a kernel in the head, and then we are ready for harvest. So Jesus says, if you want to know what the kingdom of God is like, it's like a seed. It's like a seed that has enormous hidden potential. And given the right ground and the right care at the right time, that will produce its potential in a way that you could never, ever imagine. And then he says, this is where he goes in for the punch. This is where the Little Red Riding Hood gets out the pistol. He says, what else can I say about this? The seed, that was a good start. It is like a seed. But I want you to know that it's like a mustard seed. Now, I'm a good little Salvo girl. I've been to primary since I didn't know what primary was. And I know about this mustard seed. And I know that it is the story that something very little can become something very big. It's a story of a little seed that becomes a big tree. Now, in my mind, I even have a lovely picture of the tree. Kind of goes in and out and in and out up to a point, and there's little birds sitting on the edges. It's all very neat and tidy and quite lovely. And this is my understanding of how the little seed became the big tree. But I want you to have a look at the picture that's about to go onto the screen. The word that Jesus used in the scripture to describe the mustard, he was talking about a weed. See the punch? Okay. Similar? Yeah. So this is a picture of the weed that they believe Jesus was referring to when he spoke. So it's okay to say, the kingdom of God is like a seed. And then, okay, the kingdom of God is like a mustard seed. But for some people standing there watching him, they would have gone, "Are you serious? Like, you cannot say that. That's ridiculous. You cannot say the kingdom of God is like a weed." But I think it's quite lovely to be shocked into thinking that the kingdom of God is like a weed. Yep. And that is exactly what I'm about to say. Well done. Good job. So what our friend here has just reminded us is that a weed grows anywhere. Sermon done. Well done. Good job. The weed that Jesus was talking about, this mustard seed, no person in that part of the world at that time would ever plant that seed in their garden because it was uncontrollable. It was very, very robust. It was very strong. It was hardy. It was drought-proof. And it would pop up where you least expected it. And this seed could go through a huge period of drought. It could appear to be gone. And all of a sudden, where you least expected it, this seed would pop up. And the one thing about this seed is that it beat all the other plants in the area because as soon as the seed dropped, it germinated straight away in the ground. Do you see what Jesus is saying? Yes, the kingdom of God is like a seed. It has enormous potential and it will grow where it's planted. But this kingdom of God will never be controlled. This kingdom of God will never be contained. This kingdom of God was and is designed to be something that will slowly take over the world as we know it. And that's why Jesus said, "What shall I use? What can I use to liken it?" Well, the best thing I can liken it to at this moment is a mustard seed. Now, the thing that challenges me about this is that this is the kingdom that I pray into this world. This is the kingdom that I ask for when I say, "Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be your name, thy kingdom come." This is the kingdom that I pray into my life, that I try to bring to life with my actions and my words. And this is a kingdom that is incredibly strong, but it will be what it is, and it will look like what it's going to look like, and it will grow where it's going to grow without my understanding and my control. Now, some of the people that listened to Jesus that day would have been very, very shocked by what he said. And in fact, some of the people would have said, "We don't actually want any part of that kingdom. We want to be like a seed that's big and strong and everybody looks at it and thinks, wow. I don't want to be part of a kingdom that's like a weed. But I want to be part of a kingdom that's like a weed. I want to be part of a kingdom that is within me and around me and growing in a way that I can notice something new every single day." So we take encouragement today from the Word of God that says, this is what the kingdom of God is like. The kingdom of God is like a seed. It has potential inside it that we will never fully understand. But given its time, it will grow and it will thrive and it will bring an amazing harvest, which is what it was designed to do all along. We're going to celebrate that kingdom of God by singing, "This kingdom shall know no end." This kingdom that is within me, that flourishes, that grows, that changes, that brings amazing fruit. That's the kingdom that is moving across this town, this city, this country. And one day we will see the hidden yet very powerful potential that lays within it. Let's sing. Has come. This is not a kingdom that we wait for. We wait for the fullness of the kingdom, but the kingdom has come to us and to our world, and we declare that today as we sing those words. Let's pray. Jesus, we thank you for your story all those years ago that challenged, and we thank you today for our capacity to be continually challenged by what we read in the scripture. We ask that you would never let us get to a point where we assume that we already know what we are reading or what you would like to tell us. We thank you for the reminder today that you bring into being a kingdom that will never be controlled and that will never be contained. And we ask that as that kingdom takes hold of our lives and of our community, we would find great joy in serving you and sharing you with those who would like to hear. We ask these things in the name of Jesus. Amen. Thank you, Emma. That was wonderful. It's an old story from my childhood that I don't think about very often, but it's nice to hear it in another way. This morning I feel like I've been transported back in time a bit as we've sung some older songs that have gone through the church for years, and the band message was a bit older and, well, an adaptation of an older song, but still very good in our story of the mustard seed. So now we're going to be reminded of the great faithfulness of our God so we can carry that into our week as we spread the mustard seed in our world and expand our kingdom. So won't you please stand as we sing, "Great is Thy Faithfulness."
Thank you.
into the world to expand our Lord's kingdom. May the Lord bless you and protect you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen. May the Lord bless you each.
Thank you. trumpet of the Lord shall sound, and time shall be no more. And the morning breaks eternal, bright and fair. When the Savior net shall gather over on the other shore, and the roar is caught up, you'll never be there. When the roar